Hi everybody, welcome back. My name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. Today we are going to talk about resizing windows on a Mac using just the native resizing tools, but also Duelist and another extension called Window Resizer and what some of those things can do. There's been a lot of questions about how to resize windows when I'm in a Google Meet or I'm presenting in a Jamboard or different things like that. So let's jump into it. So first, what we're going to do is we're going to just talk about how to resize windows just natively on a Mac, how you can make them even, had multiple windows, stuff like that. So this is a new window here, and we have three options up here. It's a little bit different. We're in Chrome, not Safari, but on a PC, the options are over on the right-hand side, and they're a little bit different. So today we're just gonna go through the Mac. So obviously to close the window, we're gonna hit the red button. I'm not gonna close it because I want this open. To minimize, here, right? This takes this down to basically our toolbar, right? Where we have all of our apps and all the things that we have going on down here. When we hit this green, right? This is a maximize full screen. So what that does actually, that will pull our menu from the top and our toolbar from the bottom. So what if I wanted to go full screen, but I don't want to lose the toolbar or different things like that? What you have the option to do is to basically double click on the corners and that will take it full screen. Not only can you double click on the corners when you're moving things around, but you can double click on the top or on the left or right. And what that'll automatically do, you can see my cursor right here. When I double click there, it'll automatically take that all the way out. That also works, again, if we're on the corner up here, if I shrink this in, if I double click here, it's gonna expand this all the way to the edge of the screen. You'll notice it doesn't take up the whole screen because I still have my menu at the top. And if I come down here, you'll see that I have the toolbar down here at the bottom. And I basically the menu bar at the bottom. Once I hit the maximize button, what that does is it's gonna enter full screen. This is where you can start to play with sliding back and forth between windows, and that's going to be on your trackpad or your mouse or however the settings that you have set up on your Mac. And to leave that, you basically hit the screen button again, and it'll take it back to full screen. So the other cool thing that we have is we can do a multi-shrink. So if I hold the option button down, which is the one that has the line and the little left to right angle, I'll try and put a picture right here. If I hold that down, it will shrink both sides at the same time. And that works all the way around. So if I hit control, you'll notice that I'm pulling the inside and, or the top and the bottom. And on the left and the right, it will keep going till it gets all the way to the edge of the screen. And then it'll shrink back so I can drag this as much as I want. So I'm gonna open a new window by hitting Command N. And you'll notice whenever I open a new window, the most recent window that I used is going to be the size of the new window. So I have two windows that are exact the same. Showed you this a little bit earlier. Let's say we're in Classroom and we also want to have a Meet going on the other side. So we're doing some grading on the right, we're monitoring our class on, or we're doing our Google Classroom on the left and we want to monitor our Meet on the right. Well, what you can do is if we hover over or hold down, it gives us the option to enter full screen or to tile the window on the left side of the screen. So we can tile that to the left. And once I click on this right window, it'll automatically tile. So now I've got an even split of my windows. Now, this is great because it gives us a 50-50 view. If I drag that gray bar in the middle, I can move this around however I want. And you'll notice if I join or start a meeting, the window size, again, I'm gonna mute myself and take that off, will fit here. And that's about as far as we can go, right? Is a 30, it looks like a 30-70, right? Now, I'm going to exit this. Come back over here. This automatically went full screen. Next to this. So now we've got these two windows. This is where Duelist comes into play because Duelist will actually give us those ratios. So Duelist is a Google Chrome extension here. When I click on this, it's going to give us a 3:7 or 30:70, right? If you're looking at the whole screen, a 6:4, 5:5, 4:6. So when I click on 5:5, this is going to go to my left, and this will go to my right. And you'll see that I have the 50-50 split. But what if I want to go to a 3? You'll notice right here, I still have the 5 over here. I can come over to the 7, it's going to give me a 30:7 or 3:7 split, right? That's what Duelist allows us to do, is have multiple windows at the same time. There are some other extensions that resize the entire window based on the program that you're using. And so one of those, which I enjoy, is this one right here. What this allows you to also is to have a pop-up in a new window. So if I open up a new window, you'll notice that the meat actually gets pulled right out here in this window. And I can resize this to the size of an iPad, to the size of a phone, or I can go full laptop mode and that basically goes full screen. And you'll notice this is just the window. And it pulled that out straight from the meat tab here, right? So you can do that with Gmail, you can pull out your email, right? So email has a pop-out that'll allow you to do that internally, but now you can actually just pull that all the way out and have a window here. So I'm gonna close this and we'll show you again. So the other options that you can have, you can set your main window just to the size of a phone, right? It's a little bit bigger than a phone. You'll see that those options are gone now. We can go all the way to a desktop. And you'll notice that this covers my whole screen. So if I am using a projector, I'm projecting onto another computer, this will basically pixelize and it'll fill that entire screen. So if you're on a projector, or if you're using an Apple TV, or if you're using a Miracast or something like that, you can resize your window without having to do this manually every time. So the other resizing window right here is, this is built for any kind of setup that you want. So based on the size that you want, you can resize, and basically that visual will pull that resizing tool right to the one you want. So there's the one on top. If we do the bottom right corner, you'll see. I don't love this one unless I'm projecting on another screen where I need to adjust it for that screen, or if I'm working with a desktop on a Mac. The two that I love are Duelist here, and this one, which is the photo resizer. I will put links to both of them below. Hopefully this helps you as you're going into online learning, online teaching, online everything, or if you're trying to manage what's happening in your classroom and you're teaching live, but you've also got your computer recording in front of you. That way you could have your Meet link over on the left. You could see the other things that you have over on the right. Sorry, my two hands, you can't see my two hands. And you can see everything that's happening, because if we're being realistic, you're running a Google Meet, recording yourself. Some of you may have kids, right, sitting behind this computer, participating in class, and also having kids at home watching the Google Meet. And so you've got to be monitoring what's happening on the Meet or the Zoom, and then in the classroom as well. Behaviorally wise, it's going to be amazing. I'm interested to see all the things that come out of this as far as what's happening. That's what some of our teachers are doing in our building. But wanted to thank you for your time today. I love you. I appreciate you. If you have any questions, go ahead and put them below in the comments, and I will add the two links to the extensions in the comments below for the resizing tool and Duelist.